Okay, I wanted to talk about some herd stuff going on here. So, what we have going on here is you see Mr. T there, the black horse. Okay, see that? Kind of, this little horse right here to the left that's closest to you by himself, the one that's got his tail swishing, that's excited. You could probably hear him. The other mare walking to him is kind of his girlfriend. This horse is new. See him fronting? See him trying to impress Mr. T? He's trying to get his mare. Buddy's just kind of wants to play with him, saying, hey, you want to play? Mr. T, the black horse, is throwing his head. Watch him. He's throwing his tail. Look at him, arching his neck. See, buddy? He wants to play. The blonde horse, he gave a little kick as he walked by and says, hey, I'm trying to get my woman. So this little horse, look, Tanner, throwing his head. This is insecure. You hear that? You hear that, Winnie? That's insecure. He's nervous. He's calling his little mare. So now his little mare is looking at Mr. T coming over there. Don't you come over there. You're my mare now. So what I did is I just put Mr. T in here to eat with this little mare because she's usually by herself. But these two horses have bonded over this fence. So now he's all upset. And he's trying to get flashy. He's trying to impress her. He's trying to tell the other horses, hey, she's mine. See him? You can't hear him, but he's honking. A lot of people ask me what honking is. I discussed that on several videos. Plus, if you look up sheath noise or honking, if you use my new search engine on the homepage of my site, you'll be able to see. And it'll explain honking and that squeaking and sounds like a lot of people describe it different ways. But you'll know it when you hear it. Okay, this horse, you hear that, Winnie? This is a very, see how Mr. T has kind of cornered his mare over there? I see she just broke away. That mare got away and said, he's calling me. I have to go see her. Look at Mr. T. No, you don't. He just cut her off and said, you do not go see her. So now she's going to try to come through here to get to her little boyfriend because they've bonded. Mr. T says, hey, 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 you're mine. So there goes Mr. T staying in between, pushing off the lower. This is what they would do in a herd, except they would have room to run. They wouldn't get hurt. But you notice Mr. T, see, showing his buddy, saying, hey, don't mess with me. Buddy's going to come over and go, hey, what's going on? Let's play. See this horse right here? Him and Mr. T are really, for you that y'all don't watch my videos, Mr. T's the big black Mustang, the one on the other side. The blonde horse right here is Buddy, little Palomino. I'm not sure what this little guy's name is. He was just brought in. Really insecure, really nervous, and he's really bonded with his little stallmate or his cellmate because they're both locked in stalls. So he's honking. I don't know if you can hear that. I wish you could hear that. Very, very kind of nervous, stressful. That's a stressful whinny. That's a calling. That's a come to me. That's that. If when you hear, see, Buddy's gonna see. Buddy wants to play, but this little guy is too focused on getting a woman. This horse has much more herd skills than Buddy, so he's really like, hey, I want my little friend. I want my horse back. Now he does the same thing. Very nervous, Winnie, very calling, tail's active. Look at that head, pacing, prancing, all done to impress, to draw attention, to look. Buddy's gonna come over there and go, hey. He's kind of starting his little stud pile there. You notice he's pooping over his own poop, kind of marking his area a little bit. Studs will do that in the wild to kind of mark their area. They're called stud piles. You see, see, that's how horses get hurt. You got poles and stuff, and they strike. Now, all they're out in the pasture, they would do that. There's no pole. They may hit each other. They'd kind of work it out, probably spin their butt, kick at each other, and then move on. Because we put stalls, we increase this anxiety. We increase this will to fight. And when I tell people stalls are bad, and everybody wants to tell me, well, he has a friend next to him. You create this horse that's protective of his area, that only knows how to fight over a fence, that becomes unsocial because he never gets his butt kicked and never has to move away. He can always win on his side of the fence. So he continues to fight. He never loses. No one either wins, and they continue to fight, and you end up creating stall aggressive horses, and horses get blamed, and then horses are locked up, or they put hot wire between them because they have to protect the horse, or they put walls, or they separate them. And it's all because horses are kept apart. I can't say it enough. Horses do best when they're with together. You notice Mr. T over there in the corner? He's got that little mare pinned in there. He said, look, woman, I told you you're mine. Stay with me. And she's like, but my friend's calling me. And Mr. T's like, I don't care. Stay over here. I don't want you by him. He's trying to tell her, I control your feet. I move your feet, I control your feet, I can prevent you from moving, therefore I'm higher, therefore you must respect me. He's not being mean, he's not being angry, he's not doing it to punish her, he's not doing it for any other reason than to say, I control your feet, stay with me, you're mine, you belong to me. And she respects that, she likes that, she wants a strong leader. If he was weak and she kept getting away, she would ignore him more, she would start kicking him, she would start treating him disrespectful and say, screw you, you can't even stop me from moving, you can't control me, I don't want to be with some weak dude. Which is why a lot of horses kick, bite their owners, because they have weak, lovable owners that don't understand horses, and they don't understand that when I control your feet, when I stop you, when I dominate, when I prevent you from doing what you want, when I trap you, when I put you in small areas, when I help you deal with your fear, they gain respect. Buddy's pawing, he's probably gonna lay down. He's looking, he's circling. You can tell his head when he's standing. He's looking for rocks, he's making sure there's nothing he's gonna fall through. He's obviously feeling a little safe in there. So he may go ahead and lay down and roll. Again, I just put these two horses in there 10 minutes ago and gave him a little hay, and within 10 minutes, Tanner pretty much said, hey, this mare is mine. I don't know why you keep going to this fence. Now there's another little mare on the other side of the fence, that little paint, and she's usually out in pasture with him, so she kind of wants to hang with Mr. T and Buddy too. Okay, this little mare's kind of getting away. See how she slowly snuck away? Here she goes. She'll come to the fence. Mr. T's gonna come over and cut her off. Oh, he got her. He cut her off before she got here. Every time he cuts her off and prevents her from moving, he gains hierarchy. He gains, now see, Buddy's starting to learn I can push this guy away. He's starting to learn that Mr. T's keeping the other mare away, so I'll kind of show dominance. So these horses are learning from each other, and I discussed that, and I just did a new page on opposition reflex, and I'll put a link in the description, and it's a separate page on my website, but if you go to the horsemanship page, there's a little link, and it says opposition reflex. And I kind of explain about how horses need that pressure and pressure and what they need, and how they perceive pressure. So if you haven't read that, go check that out. Buddy's by the fence. The other little guy probably took a break. He got upset. You got this other little paint out here kind of still stalking the fence saying, hey, come out with me. What's going on? This little guy grabbed a mouth of food. Now he's going to go back. Now, will this work out? Sure. Will they get tired of this? Yeah. Could they possibly one of them rear and get hurt on that pole? Yeah. Could they possibly get over and bite the other one? Yes. Do you want to prevent this? Well, it depends. I want to prevent it by letting them out in pasture. I don't want to prevent it by putting up pop wire that shocks them and make them more insecure. I don't want to stop all horse behavior so my horse will be quiet and he won't make noise and he won't run back and forth and he'll just stand in his stall or his cell like a caged prisoner, to where he kind of gives up and he's dull and he has no drive and he has no herd instincts and he has no willingness to be with his buddy because he gets shocked from hot wire or because he gets locked up or because somebody builds a wall and says he's going to get hurt, so I have to protect him. All those things are wrong. These horses are being, see that little front there? See, he kind of showed a little dominance, raised that leg, threatened Buddy. Remember, in herds, in predators, sometimes predators fight to the death. So when a predator fights, they tend to fight more aggressively, and they fight to win and to either kill or damage or wound the other predator. However, in prey animals, when they fight, it's more about fronting each other off. It's more about displaying dominance. It's more about threatening. It's more about appearing tougher, because they know that they're prey animals, and if they get hurt, they're going to get eaten by the predators. So prey fighting is normally not as aggressive. Now you can go to Korea where they stupid do these stud fightings. They put a mare in heat out there and then they bring two stallions out and they hold them on ropes and make them fight to the death and bite and hurt each other. That's only because humans are involved and doing their cruel, stupid stuff. Out in the wild, that doesn't happen. Usually a stallion will dominate. He'll drop the lower stallion to his knees. He may get a kick in, he may get a bite. The other horse will yield before he gets so hurt that he becomes food for the predators. So when you see a horse throwing his head, threatening, pin his ears, swishing his tail, stomping his feet, arching his neck, doing all these normal horse things, the horse is trying to display and show dominance, and that's how prey animals kind of fight. So when you see some dumb A human beating them and whipping them and tearing them up and putting chains on them and shocking them and doing all this other crap. That's how dumb predators fight. Big difference between predators and prey. And if people understand that, then they'll understand horses better. So we'll end that there. Hope that helps on a little herd behavior. Seeing Mr. T, he's got his mare back there pinned in the corner. Now, real quick before I leave, I'm going to describe this like a lot of people in the horse world, mainly women, who would describe this. And then I'll describe it on how a horse sees it, or what I think a horse sees. Look at that mean horse. He's got that poor little mare trapped in a corner. He's just being mean. He's keeping her from water, and he's making her stand in that corner, and there ain't no sense in that. He's just being mean to her. And that little horse didn't do anything, and he's got that little mare. That Mr. T is just a mean, bad horse. He's got that poor, see it arching in the neck? See right here, I had a chain. See that stomping? See that loud noise? Buddy's trying to reach over here and kind of, they're sniffing. They're kind of showing each other a little. He's going to spin his butt, say, smell my strength, smell my butt. He may kick out, but he walked away. He's swishing his tail. Maybe it flies, but it could be to show dominance. It could be to show, hey, I'm not worried about you. Hey, I'm walking away with an attitude. All right, so let me go back to my other thing because I can't stay on track here. As one guy puts it, I like to chase rabbits in the field a lot. If you ever seen a dog out in the field, the rabbit will jump out and he'll be running off. You call him back, he'll be your buddy, you'll be petting him. Next thing you know, rabbit jumps out and he's out chasing another rabbit, and then he comes back. That's kind of what I do on these tapes. I'm always out changing topics, but I think it's important. There she goes, she's breaking away. She tried to break right. Mr. T's pinned his hair. Look at his snaking. He dropped his head. She's trying to cut through. He cut her off. Look, he's going to come this way. He's going to stay in between the threat, the higher horse. He's going to go back and get his mare. My buddy's going to come in and go, yeah, that's right, baby. Yeah, I'm with Mr. T. Buddy, you big little pansy. Okay, so back to my different ways of seeing things. And this is the problem I see in the horse world right now. There's too many people hearing consistently the first way I describe this. You hear too many women out there putting personalization on this who don't understand horses, who have no idea about horse behavior, and all you hear is women talking about how bad the horse is and how mean and how that horse bit my horse and that horse kicked my and that horse is mean and that horse chased that poor little mare to the corner and that horse is protecting the water and he won't let any other horse drink. That horse is just mean. We need to get together and tell the barn manager that that horse has to be locked up because he's mean and he won't let my poor little mare have a drink. That's the problem with horse world right now, people, is people don't understand horses. They don't see horses for horses, and they can't see it as the natural instinctive beauty that horses have. Mr. T, of course, he moved to the back here because I can't see anything. He is displaying and exhibiting normal horse behavior. He's exhibiting good herd behavior. He is showing what a good horse does. He's keeping busy. He's keeping mentally fit. Here goes a little mare, broke away. She's going to try to come through here. Mr. T can't cut her off because there's a doorway, because stupid humans built it to where she can block him off. Mr. T's going to push her through. He's going to say, keep going, woman. You're mine. Get over there. He's moving her feet. He's controlling her. He's dominating her. He's showing strength. He's showing dominance. He's doing all the things that if people understood horses, they would do that to their horse, and they wouldn't have all these problems. Okay, there's Mr. T. Poor little mare. That mean Mr. T locked her in a corner. He's being mean to her. She loves it. She loves him. She's happy. Her drive is to get to the other mare that she's comfortable with. But she also, her drive is to be with a stronger male. So although she's being locked in the corner and she's being taught, it's her feet are being controlled, and she's not being allowed to move what she wants, she likes that from Mr. T. This little guy's laying down right here. He pawed a little bit. Now he's going to go ahead and could be getting a dirt bath for the flies, and that's okay. That's good for him. He's shining his coat up. Get up, shake some of that excess dirt off. He may go to the other side now. He is. He's going to lay down, go to his other side. Again, getting a dust bath. There's so many people. Another thing that I see all the time. Women be running out here. I just gave you a bath, you stupid horse. You were so clean and pretty, and now look at you. You're dusty and dirty. I'm going to lock you. I'm putting a blanket on you, and I'm going to lock you up because you're a stupid horse. I tried to clean you and you smelled nice, and now look at you, you're all dirty like a stupid horse. Okay, people, those are all the wrong things. Those are the things that I try to discount. And then that's when I get hate mail, because I sound like probably 90% of the horsewomen and horses right now. And when they hear that, they're going to go, he's talking about me. This guy's an asshole. I don't like him. I'm going to flag his video. I'm going to complain to YouTube. I'm going to send him a dirty email. You freaking people don't understand horses and just want to personalize it, just irritate the crap out of me. Some lady sent me a nice video. She said as a tribute to Mr. T and Buddy, she showed her horse. She put some good comments on there about how she's happy her horse is happy in the pasture. I tried to share it. I put it on YouTube. Then she sends me an email whining and complaining about, I spelt it wrong, or I'm going to look like a fourth grader, or people are going to think that I don't want people. And she blocks the video. Now, you know, that's some personal petty crap. That's some typical woman crap that it suddenly becomes about her and her image and what she looks like and how she appears to others, and it's all about her. So as far as I'm concerned, she's been a loyal viewer. She's written me a lot of nice comments. I thought she was getting it about horses, and that comment right there tells me she don't get it. She's still a petty personal human that wants to make it about her instead of about the horse and improving the horse world and horsemanship and sharing good things about the horse. It suddenly becomes about how she's gonna look. How's she gonna appear? So she makes her video private. I thought that was pretty petty and crappy, but you know, whatever. I've just came to accept the fact that there's a lot of women out there that are used to getting things sugar-coated and handed to them, and they want it their way, and if they don't get it their way and you're not nice and you don't make it sound good and pretty and sweet and nice and you don't kiss their butt, well, then they're not gonna like you and they're gonna make blogs about you and talk crap. Well, knock yourself out. I don't care. It's about the horse. And you know what, if it takes me taking a little abuse, I'm going to put the info out, and those that want to learn can, and those that want to improve and understand horses will, and those that want to remain in their petty human mindset and describe crap wrong and think they know everything and wear their fancy little boots and tight brown pants, knock yourself out. So anyway, got off on a tangent there, but now Buddy's gotten in on the act. Buddy has moved over there with Mr. T. Now, again, someone else is going to see, look at those two. Rick's horses are mean. Look, Buddy and Mr. T, and you know what? He probably taught him to do that because he's an asshole. He probably made them be mean to that woman because he don't like women, so he makes his horses treat women bad. Give me a freaking break, people. Get a life. Good boy, Mr. T. You be a horsey. Mr. T is training Buddy. That's another good point that I miss a lot. When your horses get out there and learn, they learn, again, I talk about this in Opposites Reflex, they learn what they see. When you have good herd horses like Mr. T and Buddy, that is good for your horse because they learn how to be a horse. They understand herd instinct. They understand pressure and release. They understand when you stop their movement and you can create movement. They reinforce all the things that make it easier for you to train your horse. Of course, in the horse world, everybody's thinking, that messes my horse up. I can't control him. He's Buddy Sour. He only wants to be with horses. And they make up all these crazy rules, and they don't understand. Mr. T is training this mare to release from pressure. He's teaching her to follow him. He's teaching her how to listen to a higher horse. He's making the owner's job easier. Of course, nobody's going to see that doesn't understand a horse. All right, kind of went off a lot of different topics there. Hope that helps. Remember, it's about the horse. I put a little link also on my Facebook Think Like a Horse page about reading The Guy in a Glass. And to prevent the hate mail, you can replace The Gal in a Glass. I don't care. The point is, be able to look at yourself at the end of the day and do what you think's right. And, you know, if you understand a horse and you give a horse, I always say I wish on people that they have to come back as a horse and get the same care they give their horse. And you know, if I came back as a horse, I'd be pretty happy if I was given care like Buddy and Mr. T. So I got no problem coming back in a horse getting the same care that I gave. But there's a whole bunch of people out there that if they came back on a horse and had to drink dirty, stinky, grungy water that wasn't clean but once every 6 months, and their food was thrown on the ground, they were locked in a cage and covered with a blanket and never allowed to be with other horses, surrounded by hot wire, I hope they're ready for a life like that if they ever come back as a horse. But we'll end that there. Buddy and Mr. T, you're good old boys. You teach that mare some manners. Good boys. Good boys.
freeze!
Well, in that there.